बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम आसिम कयूम फ्राम APS दमयाल। आई वेलकम यू टू एपसेक्स ऑनलाइन स्पोर्ट प्रोग्राम। आई एम हेयर विद द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ लेक्चर नंबर 4 इन विच वी शैल डिस्कस न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 10। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद न्यूमेरिकल नंबर 1 इन विच टाइम पीरियड ऑफ द सिंपल पेंडुलम इज 2 सेकेंड एंड ग्रेविटेशनल एक्सेलरेशन ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ अर्थ इज 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड। ग्रेविटेशनल एक्सेलरेशन ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ मून इज GE/6। वी हैव टू फाइंड द लेंथ ऑन अर्थ एज वेल एज ऑन मून। हेयर इज द डेटा इन विच GM इज इक्वल टू GE/6। वी कैलकुलेट इट 1.6 मीटर पर सेकेंड। Now, the formula for this numerical is T is equal to 2π/L/g. For Earth, the length becomes LE and gravitational acceleration becomes GE. Squaring on both sides to get T square is equal to 4π² LE/g. We have to find length of the pendulum on the surface of earth. We separate it, we get T square into GE divided by 4π². Now, putting the values we have given, we get the answer LE is equal to 1.202 meters. Now, same process we will continue for moon, in which we use LM and GM. We get the answer 0.17 meters. In next numerical, we have given the pendulum length is 0.99 meters on the surface of moon and the time period of the pendulum is 4.9 seconds. We have to find the gravitational acceleration on the surface of moon as given in the data. So again we are using the same formula, Tm time period of the pendulum is equal to 2π L/g. For the surface of moon we use Lm and Gm. Squaring on both sides we get Tm square 4π² Lm/gm. We have to find the gravitational acceleration, so we will separate it by cross multiplying. Gm is equal to 4π² Lm divided by Tm square. In this way, putting the values, Lm is 0.99 and Tm is 4.9 square, we get the value of gravitational acceleration on the surface of moon, that is 1.63 meters. In the third numerical, we have given the length of the simple pendulum which is 1 meter and the gravitational acceleration on the surface of Earth is 10 meter per second square, and the on the surface of moon is 1/6 of the value, which is 10. So that is 1.67 meter per second. We have to find the time period on the surface of Earth as well as on Moon. Formula used for this purpose is T is equal to 2π√L/g. For Earth, that is TE, which is equal to TE is equal to 2π√L/GE. We put the values and we get the answer 2 seconds. Similarly, for the case of moon, Tm is equal to 2π√L/gm, and putting the values and we get the answer, that is 4.9 seconds. Numerical you have to solve yourself. We are going to discuss 10.5 numerical, in which we have given the number of waves passing through a point is 100 in 20 seconds. Total time is given, which is 20 seconds. The wavelength is given, which is 6 centimeter. We have to calculate frequency, time period and wave speed. Like this, number of waves passing to certain time medium is 100 and total time is 20 seconds. Wavelength is 6 centimeter, which is equal to 0.06 meters. Frequency is equal to number of waves divided by total time, which is equal to 5 hertz. Now, the time period is reciprocal of the frequency, so we will get the value 1 by 5, which is equal to 0.2 second, and wavelength we have given, which is 0.06 meters. We will find the wave speed with the help of formula V is equal to F lambda. Putting the value F is equal to 5 hertz multiply by 0.06, we get 0.3 meters per second. In 10.6 numerical, we have given the frequency of the ripple tank, which is 12 hertz, and wavelength, which is equal to 3 centimeter. We convert it into the SI unit, which is 3 divided by 100, which is equal to 0.03 meters. We have to find the wave speed. Wave speed formula is V is equal to F lambda. Putting the value F and lambda, we get the speed 0.36 meter per second. In 10.7 numerical, we have given the frequency of the wave, which is 190 hertz, and it travels through a distance or length of 90 meters in total time of 0.5 second. We have to find the time period of the wave, speed of the wave and wavelength lambda of the wave. In this numerical, the time period is the reciprocal of the frequency, so that can be found 1 by f, which is 1 by 190, which is equal to 0.005 seconds. And next, we have to find the wave speed. Wave speed can be found with the help of formula distance divided by time, that is 90 divided by 0.5 second, which is 180 meter per second. We have given the wave speed, which is 180 meter per second, we just have found. We have the formula V is equal to F lambda. In this formula, wavelength can be separated with the help of formula V divided by F. Now wavelength becomes 180 divided